George.
Hello.
Betty.
Hello, who's there?
Good Lord. Olsen here.
Oh, Olsen.
Hello, Mr. Olsen. Well, Mr. Olsen.
How are you both?
Oh, very well.
Fine, thank you.
And how are you getting on?
Very well, no regrets. I'm very happy. I wouldn't come back if you offered me all the gold in China.
Oh, well.
I'm perfectly well and perfectly happy, and I can't tell you how marvellous it is to be dead. I've never known, well, you know, I was very interested in all this, and
yes,
I used to go to the meetings and the science.
Oh,
no, that's a few years ago. My goodness me, people should consider themselves lucky the day they kick the bucket.
Mr. Austin, what were your feelings when you first found yourself over?
Well, fortunately, I knew quite a bit about it before I came.
Yeah.
That was a great blessing and a great help. Believe me, it was. Oh, I was a bit, I suppose, like everyone must be at first, a bit shaken in a way. I suppose we have our own idea of things and what we've been told one way and another, but
yeah.
I think the reality of it all, the naturalness of it all, is the thing that surprised me. I suppose it shouldn't have done, but it did.
Well, what sort of condition did you find yourself in? What sort of place or, you know...
Well, as far as I'm concerned, the place in which I found myself was, I suppose the nearest one can say, is like some country place. Could be anywhere, in a sense. I mean, there were the trees, and the birds, and just as if one was waking up in a country... A village, although in a sense it wasn't a village, I realized that very soon afterwards, thousands and thousands of people, many, many, I suppose what you'd call apartment houses, anyway, I suppose that's what you'd call them, vast buildings housing thousands of people, all sounds like a... Rather like a large council estate, but nothing like that, really.
No,
very beautiful, extremely beautiful setting, a sort of woodland setting, and beautiful scenery everywhere, even lakes. I mean, it was just as if you... We were waking up, as it were, in a kind of country setting in the late summer. Everything was very quiet and peaceful, and yet one soon realized there was a great deal of activity going on. There was no noise of any description, and the animals, there seemed to be many, many animals, and indeed I realize there are many animals here, particularly in regard to domestic animals. Cats and pets and people have had on earth, you know, that they still have over here, but they live in communities. There are separate houses, there are people who do have separate houses, but that seems to come, as far as I can make out, to most people after a time. It doesn't necessarily happen all at once. There are probably exceptions. I think this place, in fact, I realize this place which I first came to was a kind of reception station, is the only way I can put it, because it's pretty obvious that quite a lot of people, when they first come, they do need help and care and attention. They need to be sort of helped through, I suppose for many people, a difficult situation or a difficult period. But for some people, it's very difficult at first. That's why this knowledge, if you have this knowledge, it's a tremendous help to you, because you realize very quickly the whole situation, and you have the advantage of knowing that you can make a contact, and those people near and dear to you, if they're insufficiently interested, as invariably they are, because through one's knowledge of it oneself, when on earth one's near, ones are usually aware of it, and you can usually get back and get a communication, I'm all right, don't worry about me, and everything in the garden's lovely sort of thing, and it cheers them up, it cheers us up. And, of course, we settle down probably more quickly than the average person. I think the most difficult cases are these who have strong convictions, religious convictions, narrow outlet, you know, out outlook, and oh, they find it much more difficult, and sometimes they're quite problems, you know. Oh, we have community centres, and the children, of course, are one of the greatest joys. I've seen so many children who live with their people over here. Of course, many of them, their parents are still on earth, but they're taken in charge by people usually, if possible, related to them, like perhaps might be a grandmother or so on. But if there is no close tie or relationship, there's always souls here who take charge, and we have schools for them, and they learn all sorts of things, certain things which they probably would have almost certainly learned at school on earth, but many other things which are much more important. But you know, there are vast cities here. I mean, not just, as I've just explained, the place I first came to, which I suppose you could say was, well, it was more than a village. Oh, we have vast, vast cities, and all manner of interests, great halls of learning, great halls of music. One can study any particular thing that appeals to one, mostly of an artistic endeavor, because it seems to me, I can realize that much more now, that art and the things of the mind and the spirit are the things that are the most lasting, obviously. There's always something new, something fresh, something more interesting, some new experience, some new place to go to, new people to visit, fresh arrivals coming over from the earth, people we've known and loved, helping them settle, getting them interested in all sorts of things over here.